Welcome to Rajendra Tandon Videos. We take up another verse from Suradas's composition Bhramara Geet. Suradas was a poet of Bhakti movement. The movement empowered the masses in the country to worship God with devotion. Other poets of this movement were Kabir, Tulsidas, and Mirabai. The genesis of Bhramara Geet poems can be traced to Srimad Bhagavat Puran. According to narration in the Puran, the inhabitants of Braj could not reconcile with the loss of Krishna to Mathura. Here, to recap, I might say, Krishna had been brought up by Nanda and Yashoda in Gokul, although he had been born to Devaki and Vasudev in a jail in the city of Mathura, ruled by the tyrant Kans, who happened to be elder brother of Devaki. At a later stage, as Krishna grew up, he was called to visit Mathura, where mythologically he had to fulfill his mission to get rid of the world of the tyrant Kans, his maternal uncle. According to the narration in Srimad Bhagavat Puran, the inhabitants of Braj could not reconcile with the loss of Krishna to Mathura. The depth of their sorrow knew no bounds. Knowing of this, Krishna sent Uddhav, a childhood friend, to Braj to tell the gopis that he still remembered them, but also to explain the divinity of Krishna to his parents, Nand and Yashoda. Uddhav told Nand and Yashoda that Krishna was formless, unborn, without a beginning and an end, and omnipresent. He advised them to look for Krishna, this Krishna, rather than the child they had brought up. At this stage, the gopis who had assembled by this time took Uddhav aside and probed him to learn as much as they could about their beloved Krishna. They repeatedly chanted Krishna's name. Meanwhile, a black bee droned into this assembly. The gopis taunted Uddhav through the medium of the bee. That is why these verses are called Bhramara Geet. The verse that we are taking up today is an address by the gopis to Uddhav. Ghar hi ke baadhe raavare, nahin meet biyog vas pare, anvauge ali baavare. You are a loud mouthed person. You go on speaking without understanding our sentiments and without realizing the importance of Krishna to us. You have not suffered as we have suffered by the departure of Krishna from Vrindavan to Mathura. Bhukh mari jaye chare nahi tinuka, sinh ko yahi swabhav re, shravan sudha murli ke poshe, jog jahar na khabav re. The gopis say that a lion does not eat grass even if it is dying of hunger. Similarly, we who have been brought up drinking the sweet nectar of Ghanshyam's murali, Krishna's flute, would not eat the poison ऑफ योग, ब्रह्म योग, निर्गुण ब्रह्म, द नॉलेज ऑफ निर्गुण ब्रह्म. उधो हम ही सीख का दयो, उधो व्हाट आर यू ट्राइंग टू टीच अस. वी आर इन लव विद कृष्ण. He, our ears have enjoyed the music of his flute. Do not poison our ears with your talk of Brahma Gyan, Nishgun Brahma. तुम्हे मालूम होना चाहिए उद्धव कि हमारे कान कृष्ण की मुरली की ध्वनि रूप अमृत से पोषित हैं. अब उन्हीं कानों को अपनी योग साधना विषय कटु वाणी से पीड़ित मत करो. उधो हम ही सीख न दे हो, डोंट टीच अस ए लेसन. हरि बिन अनत न ठामरे, फॉर अस देर इज नो अदर शेल्टर बट हरि बट कृष्ण. सूरदास कहां लय कीजे थाही नदिया नावरे. For our river of love, what shall we do with a boat made of yoga? We know the depth of love in the ocean of this world, but to cross this ocean, we need Krishna. Your boat cannot be used to cross the petty river of life. It may be useful for you, but not for us. For us, Krishna's bhakti and prema is the most important. Brahmar Geet is a fabulous combination of virha, grief of separation, jnana and bhakti. It is a composition in the face of which jnana takes a back seat. Here the entire logic of yoga accepts defeat. All that remains is absolute devotion, bhakti and bhakti alone. Human beings can get mukti with Krishna's blessings. Sincere bhakti is superior to jnana. So say the gopis. Bhakti is superior to yoga. As a poet, Surdas primarily delves in Vatsalya Shringar and Shantarasa. He combined bhakti and shringar to describe union and separation with an intensity seldom achieved elsewhere. Brahmar Geet is not only one of the most sublime writings on virha and shringar. It is also a unique discussion on sagun and nirgun. In the conversations between the gopis and Uddhav, we find a witty, depathy and penetrating satire. Surdas verses not only reach a pinnacle of emotional content, but are also rated high for a poet's craft. His language is simple, expression spontaneous, and words full of learning. He is rich in imaginative similes and metaphors. Says Hazari Prasad Dwivedi, an eminent critic in Hindi, Surdas jab apne priya vishay ka varnan shuru karte hain, to mano alankar shastra haath jod kar unke piche piche daudta hai. Upamaon ki baad aa jati hai, roopakon ki varsha hone lagti hai. I stop here. I'll take up another verse tomorrow. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for visiting this site.